Yikes, that's too scary.
What's that?
It's me, Buzz.
You're looking at the cabinet for that 1929 Philco.
Wood cabinet.
And we're going to have a change of pace on this episode. We're going to work on the cabinet.
Great to get a change of pace.
Now, it does have a few problems.
But sir, I don't have any problems.
Right down here.
Where? Down there. Just down there.
With some of the veneer off. And some of this is kind of loose down here. Oops.
Oops.
In fact, that thing is ready to fall off. I'm going to be fixing that. Also here, this needs to be repaired.
Not polite to point.
I'm going
to
take this whole assembly here and this
I can't say Worcestershire.
The bezel. I'm going to take the bezel off. There's a nice close-up of the bezel. This grill cloth has seen better days.
Wow!
Right here, this piece, you see, is ready to fall off. I just took it off right there.
You're embarrassing me.
Some of this is a little bit loose. We'll have to re-glue some of this.
We're loose!
And first, we're going to take this piece off. And the bezel. There's a label on the bottom of the cabinet. Philco radio speaker. I can't read the model. There's the grill cloth and the speaker assembly.
That's ugly!
It's screwed onto this plywood here. And looks like this is some screws here.
You see this bulb here? You just unscrew this.
Mm-hmm. Wow, that was fast.
All right, looks like there was 8 screws in it. Let's see what happens here. There it is. This time it's been off.
It's been a long time since I was a pony.
Long time.
No, don't touch me.
There's some damage here. Looks like it's been cracked.
Rosie, you're cracked.
Right about here.
I'll let you fondle my chest.
I don't know what I'm going to do with this. We'll have to think about it.
Don't think. Feel.
Huh. I can still see a pencil mark here. Can you see that?
I didn't even bring a pencil on the first day of school.
Okay, let's get the bezel off. We got 4 screws here. Let's take it out. Go. This is in very good shape.
Yeah, it's good shape too.
Don't want to damage this puppy.
And he ain't no puppy.
You see, there's 2 holes here.
Are those bullet holes?
One is for the power switch. And there was another one here for a phono plug. And this model doesn't have it, because I see no signs of it. Usually that's not...
Huh?
It's not punched out here, but this one got punched out somehow. Anyway. There's a pencil mark here.
What of it?
Maybe that's from the original...
Them's all original parts. They ain't easy to come by.
Person who did this. Anyway, I think this has been glued here. I think this was cracked. I think it was glued. This one too, maybe.
It's a mess. It's like a pig pen.
Looks like, this area here. No, I don't think it's been glued here. I think it's just some of that came off.
Yeah, that's messed up.
Not my mess.
Well, it may have been. I don't know.
I don't know either.
Let me turn it around. Looks like this original color was green. Green and gold. I don't know if the camera could pick that up.
You don't even own a camera.
Sure looks like that to me. In fact, I thought the power cord had a greenish color to it.
Oh, green! Yes, green!
Anyway. Let me see if I can take that off.
Fast.
It's coming off pretty easy.
Not so fast.
Looks like I got a hanky now. Don't blow your nose on that. I wonder if anybody has anything like that out there. Anybody has a green fabric like that, let me know.
Just let me know.
Alright, here's the piece. It's basically just plywood.
All carved out of wood.
You can see here there's a one layer, thin layer, then a middle layer, and then a top layer. So.
Yep.
Probably very cheap wood.
Real cheap.
Here, you can see where it was cracked here and repaired. Not repaired very well.
I can repair it right away and have it for you tonight.
If you see here, there's the separation. We'll have to ponder that.
I'll have to give the matter a little thought.
I can just put some wood putty in there and be done with it.
Huh?
I'll go ahead and think about that and we'll get back to the video later.
Crap.
After examining this thing,
This needs closer examination.
The fatal weak point.
Fatal weakness.
Is, I don't know if you can see it. I'll draw. There's a split right here. That easily could have been kicked in.
Which one of y'all kicked me?
And when that got loose, this whole thing.
You failed.
You know, you can see that. It moves and it just weakens everything.
I'm too weak.
So that'd be the first point I'm gonna glue. I'm just seeing if I can repair this. I have no tools to cut anything like this, so I'm gonna fix it to the best of my ability, which is not much, but.
Where's your glue, you dirty rat?
I'll give it a shot. I need my X-Acto knife. Try to rub some of the glue in there.
Spread it around a little bit, you know?
You know, I don't know what I would do without one of these. I couldn't do radios without an X-Acto knife. It's a great tool. I can use it for everything.
Put the knife away and shut your mouth.
I'm gonna use this block here. I got that from a company I used to work for called NEC, Information Systems.
Never heard of it.
Screw it.
this basically would flatten that piece out. And from there, we can start on the other. See, I was playing with it earlier and this kind of just fell out. This area here is fine. That's sturdy. It's just this one area. It's
a weak link.
This one area here is bad.
Oh, you bad boy.
So this is gonna take a few days just to get this thing done. Make sure that's tight. It's the next day, and I'll let it set overnight.
Time does fly fast, my son.
Let's see how it looks.
Gee, it's stuck!
Well, looks like we got it glued. Okay, this is the weak spot here. That's as solid as a rock now.
Success! 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 Success!
That ain't going anywhere. So that was good. Now, I'm gonna do step two here, and I'm gonna glue this part on.
Oh dear, not another one.
Just want to make sure that this...
What you doing? Hibernating?
Actually, this thing should... Should we glue it? That was in there crooked. So... I'll do a little sanding on there.
Looks like sandpaper.
Okay, that piece is gonna go right there.
Goody, 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 goody.
Make sure it's nice and flat.
Well, thank you, flat nose.
Okay.
Oh, Elmer's glue all. That's my Elmer's picture right there. Handsome, isn't he? And so is the plastic squeeze bottle.
You gotta glue this piece by piece, and then it'll be more strong than when it started. So I'm gonna save this piece for another day, and it's gonna put this on here.
And Elmer's glue all really sticks.
Wanted to get it in a little crevice there, which looks like I did. What I think I'll do with this
use my little vice grips as a clamp. If I can get the right angle here.
Wait a minute, let me get this straight.
Okay, here's the bottom section of the cabinet. This is where the piece came out here. There's a bunch of the veneer is flaked off here, and there's a piece here. Some of it, yeah, here's, it's ready to come off here.
Don't worry, it'll mend practically everything. Pottery, wood, paper, that's why they call it Elmer's Glue Wall.
I think.
But you're so old.
I might fill this in with some putty or something.
Huh?
Now this here, I might put a new piece of veneer on there if I can find something. In fact, I am going to do that. I'm just going to cut this off.
All I have to do now is cut the leg holes.
I've never done this before, as you can tell.
No kidding.
And this is not the way you're supposed to do it. That's the way I'm doing it.
Feels wrong.
I wonder if this cabinet could talk.
Can you not speak?
I think it could tell of all the tales it knows.
I don't know nothing. I ain't seen nothing. I'm not saying nothing.
The houses it's been in. The conversations. It's heard.
This is the most ghoulish conversation.
This conversation can serve no purpose anymore. Goodbye.
Okay, I'm gonna see if I can find some veneer that might match that. Okay, the only veneer I found was this, which it doesn't match it at all. And this really delicate piece right here, this one is the right thickness. I might use that and then I'll just have to stain it. I've glued this back in and I came out with this.
Wow, you gotta be kidding me.
Pretty much same height as, so I'm just gonna glue that in there. I know it doesn't match, but we'll make it match in the end.
You're just gonna have to mix and match.
Thank you. looks like I can trim this some more.
Just trim it a little.
Oh, crap. Well, I had a little accident there. And that broke.
Go on, lame brain.
So we're gonna stick that on there. I told you this is really delicate.
He's funny.
But this doesn't have to look perfect.
It's perfect, Dad.
In fact, I don't want it to look perfect.
Perfect my ass.
It'd be kind of neat to, the next person that gets this says, who's the idiot who did that? And I'll smile down from where I am, heaven, hopefully. And I'll laugh and say, that was me, I was the idiot.
It was me!
No hurry, take your time.
As you can tell, I'm very bad at this.
No shit, Sherlock.
But that's the funny part of it. I'm gonna let that dry. Okay, I've got the second piece cut out. We'll just spread some glue.
Here we go again.
Well, the other one just the other one just broke too. Hear the laughter already. That's okay. I expected it. It's kind of neat using this old veneer from this old radio. It's from an old Stromberg Carlson that I'll be showing you in a little while. A 30s Stromberg Carlson.
I'm fourth step!
This stuff is very, very thin. Just kind of flakes off.
Are we done here?
This other piece is from some unknown cathedral a guy gave me. Well, we'll let this dry.
It's Miller time.
Something like that. I'm not gonna worry about that or that. If I get that blended in there, you're not gonna be able to see that.
You're looking at a 1939 Stromberg Carlson. I believe it's the model 430. This is where I got that veneer from. This. Next video. We will be cleaning up the cabinet and trying to refinish it. So we'll see how that goes.
I'll try, damn it. You can't ask any more than that.
Thanks for watching.